There are many different log profiles, such as S-log, F-log, V-log, C-log, Z-log, because every camera manufacturer has its own profiles. In short, log is a specific camera profile designed to capture a very wide dynamic range, with the purpose of keeping as much details as possible in both the light and dark parts of an image, thus enabling more flexibility in post-production. The downside of using a log profile is that the recorded image looks very flat, so you must do a color correction in post. The reason for the existence of log profiles is a technological limitation. Cameras are capable of capturing only a limited dynamic range and a finite number of colors, while screens are similarly restricted in their ability to display them. These limitations are still much lower than what our eyes can see, which is a little over 20 stops of dynamic range. Now, the current standard Rec 709, which is used by every video platform and TV station, can reproduce only about 6 stops. Therefore, if you are recording a video in a high contrast situation, with very dark and very light parts present in the frame, at the same time, you will have to choose between exposing for either the highlights or shadows. Over time, cameras became much better, so today, many cheap cameras can capture around 11 stops in standard profiles and cram them into 6. More interestingly, they are capable of recording even more, and this is where log profiles come into play. When recording in a log profile, modern cameras can capture somewhere between 14 and 16 stops of dynamic range. Depending on the scene you are recording, this can make a huge difference. Another advantage of log profiles is their ability to capture more color information. These two things together result in much greater grading capability in post-production. For example, you can have much more room to play with dark and light parts of an image and push the colors. If you look at this chart, you will clearly see that the line is not straight. This curvature at the bottom and at the top represents an extended dynamic range. If you compare it to the standard Rec 709, we can also see that it's more tilted, thus covering a much wider part of the chart. Just like everything else in life, logs also have pros and cons. The main disadvantage of recording in log is that everything appears gray, leading to two problems. Firstly, you will have a hard time achieving the right exposure, and secondly, you will need to color correct your footage. To tackle these problems, you will need to learn how to use zebras and histogram or utilize gamma display assist for easier but not perfect results. Additionally, mastering color grading and working with LUTs will be essential. For those who don't know, lookup tables or simply LUTs are presets that are used to change how colors look or to convert one color space to another. In this case, you will need a LUT that transforms log footage to Rec 709, which you can download for free from your camera manufacturer. If you find this video helpful, leave a like and I'll see you in the next one.